directly behind me. What young boy hasn't had the dream of playing here on this very field? Alto, in fact, actually played left field here as a collegiate all-star. And years later, John coached and pitched to his son JJ on this very field for elite high school games. An amazing connection, I think. So, while your imagination is running, for today, let's connect things a little further. When you see the big A, imagine it stands for Alto. When you see some of the smaller A's throughout the stadium, think of Alyssa. When you see all the bright, vibrant colors throughout the stadium and in the audience, think of Carrie. So for this day, in my opinion, we are not in Angel Stadium. We are in Altobelli Stadium. So on that thought, we will begin the celebration in just a few more minutes. I see there's still a few people trying to find a seat, so if you would, give us just a couple of minutes, and we'll begin the celebration of lives. Thank you. Guess my body knew way more than I did. Doc said, you'll never play again. Worst thing I ever heard. It sounds rough, doesn't it? I wish that I knew back then. There's no perfect life. You can't hold back time, but you hold on tight, hoping you might find every page you've turned is a lesson learned. Ain't we all just trying to get it right? These are the chapters of my life.
You singing my favorite song, swinging on the front porch, just laughing at the dogs. How you swear you love me more when you're whispering goodnight. All those little moments are every reason why I'm homesick. This feeling that I'm feeling, no, we don't quit. It's like half of me is missing heaven, no. That all I wanna do is be alone with your brown eyes are tangled up, just holding on to you tonight till morning. Baby, that's the damn truth. If home is where the heart is, I'm home.
Good afternoon and welcome. Today, we're celebrating the lives of John, Carrie, and Alyssa. Their family requests that we also take a moment to remember all of those who lost their lives in the tragic accident on January 26th in Calabasas. John Altobelli, Carrie Altobelli, Alyssa Altobelli, Kobe Bryant, Gianna Bryant, Sarah Chester, Peyton Chester, Christina Chester, Ara Zobayan. Now please take a moment to reflect on their lives and pray for their families as they continue to grieve and mourn the loss of their loved ones. Thank you.
On behalf of JJ, Lexi, and Carly, thank you so, so much for attending this Celebration of Life service for John, Carrie, and Alyssa. Your presence to support this family is so, so appreciated. Today is a day to remember these three incredible people as a community. We will laugh and we will cry. And in the end, we will together show JJ, Lexi, and Carly that they are loved and will never be alone. Days like today remind me that life is a sum of defining moments, some positive and some gut-wrenching, painful. Some that you just want to think about and smile, and some that cause you to cry. Some that you cherish and hold on to, and some you just want to forget. One defining moment that I will always cherish and hold on to was in February of 2012. That was the day that I got to meet Coach Alto for the very first time. He had graciously decided to dedicate opening day of that season to my 12-year-old daughter, Jessie, who had just lost her fight to cancer. At that moment, I was a broken dad just trying to breathe. When I arrived at the field, Coach greeted me and my son, and he gave me this massive hug. That is one of the things, among many things, I'm gonna miss is an Alto hug. If you ever got one, you knew that you got a great, great hug. After our tear-filled embrace near third base, he shared how sorry he was, and then he shared that he would do anything and everything to make sure our family was supported. For the next 8 years, Coach fulfilled his promise and always made his team and his family available to help with our foundation in any way possible. Year after year, they would show up no matter what the task. One year, we needed to move these very, very large shelves. And so Coach brought the boys down and the shelves got moved. After they moved the shelves, Coach said, "Wait a minute, Eric, the vacuum, the carpet's dirty. Do you have a vacuum?" I was like, "Sure." And he's like, "Okay, boys, on it." It was never something too small for his players, for his family. They're the most generous people that I've ever met. And I think about it is because from my vantage point, he loved helping his players learn about life off the field. Sure, Alto loved to win, but he also loved to teach. And he used every moment to teach his team and his players that the greatest thing, the greatest way to define success, that's really bad, but that was funny. Yes, Alto loved all kinds of things. But the greatest way to define success is by what you give, not by what you get. And that's what Alto did all the time, was give. Days like today also remind me to thank God for the gift of time that he gave us with John, Carrie, and Alyssa, three of his great creations. Yes, their time on earth was cut way too short. But that should remind us never to take life for granted and to truly, truly appreciate each day. Last Thursday, over 500 people gathered on the lawns outside of Mariners Church to light candles in honor of Alyssa. During the gathering, some friends read an autobiography poem that Alyssa had written called Where I'm From. I'm going to quote, "I'm from holiday parties and competition. I'm from John and Carrie. I'm from comedians. I'm from athletes. I'm from let's go outside and stay aloft electronics. I'm from Christians, children of God," end quote. Because John, Carrie, and Alyssa knew God and knew they were created by God, they did whatever they could to make the world a little better and a little brighter. And I think any of you that have ever had a chance to intersect with any of those three people, you would say your life is a little better and a little brighter. Finally, days like today remind me that I have to trust God and hold on to heaven. When my daughter lost her fight to cancer, I kept asking God, why? I just didn't understand why he needed her in heaven more than I wanted her on earth. To be honest, I still don't understand, but I'm not God. So I'm left daily with a choice, to be bitter or believe in God and try my best to be better. As a Christian, I believe in the Bible, and John chapter 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life." With God's daily grace and strength, I choose to believe that heaven is real and that I will see my daughter again. And I will see John Altobelli, Carrie Altobelli, and Alyssa Altobelli. I hope we all choose to live our lives and honor them, honor Alto, honor Carrie, and honor Alyssa, and believe in God the way that they did, so life can be a little brighter and a little better too. JJ and Lexi, I really have no words. I'm so sorry. We are all here for you and we love you. The best thing that I can do is repeat what your dad shared to me 8 years ago near third base. I am so sorry, but we will always be here with you and always be here for you. May you never feel alone and may you always feel loved. Let's pray. God, we do love you. We thank you for loving John and Carrie and Alyssa, three of your great creations. We miss them so much. Please comfort their family as we celebrate them today. Lord, give them strength, joy, and peace every day of their lives. Lord, help them never feel alone and always feel loved. And God, we hold on to the power of Jesus Christ and the hope of heaven. Thank you for that gift. Thank you for your Son. It's in Jesus' precious name I pray. Amen. Please watch this.
Today is Alto's favorite day, the opening day. He loved opening day.
Good job, huh?
Thank you, yep.
Love you, buddy.
Me too. On opening day, he was always here super early, but today I beat him to the field. And it's gonna be the only time that I ever do.
Today, the Pirates of Orange Coast College will open their 2020 season in a stadium known as the house that Alto built.
When I say this is the house that Alto built, he didn't do it lightly. This was his dream job, and he loved every second of this job.
But for the first time in almost three decades, the team will be taking the field for opening day without the man who defined this program.
I've described him as the Kobe Bryant of junior college baseball because he knew how to win. Ready to go today? You ready to go? You're a good teammate?
Yep.
I know that he's proud of our guys for being out here today. Have fun today, boys. And we're gonna do the best we can to honor him in everything we do moving forward.
Steps away from the field, John Altobelli's office sits uncharacteristically silent. And still.
An unbelievable family man, an unbelievable baseball coach. He's the one I wanted to be when I grew up. And I guess at this point, I'm 49 years old, I still want to be that person.
For the last 27 years, Altobelli was the head baseball coach at Orange Coast College. He won more than 700 games. Yeah! And four state championships.
Here's the payoff. Called strike three. The Pirates, they are your 2014 champions.
What kind of values did he stand for as a coach?
His relationship with every team is always the same. He always loves his guys. He treats them with the utmost respect. He's the kind of coach that I wanted to be.
What your sons did this year is nothing short of amazing.
The reason why he was a coach was to positively impact a lot of those guys and give them a chance to be successful, not only on the baseball field, but just afterwards as a husband, as a father. That's what he really wanted from his players.
That's what he expected of himself, too.
Carrie came into our lives when I was in sixth grade, and seeing them be together, me and her would play basketball in the backyard at our old house. And we'd play for money, and I think that might have been one of the reasons that I really started liking her, because no offense, but she wasn't the best athlete. But the first time I met her, I just remember telling my dad, when he asked me what I thought, and I just said, you need to marry this girl.
John and Carrie had two daughters, Alexis and Alyssa. They were a baseball family at heart, but Alto's youngest took a different path. 13-year-old Alyssa excelled playing point guard for the Mambas, an elite eighth grade travel team coached by Kobe Bryant.
Playing on Kobe Bryant's team, you get a lot of recognition. People already had her going to Oregon on a scholarship, and I was the one that was there to try to make sure she stayed level-headed.
Did you ever play one-on-one, the two of you?
All the time.
She'd kick your ass?
No shot. Not a chance.
But of all the family memories, some of the best were in Cape Cod, where they could all be together.
That's something that Carrie, Lexi, and Lissa really enjoyed about Cape Cod was they liked the baseball part of it, but I think they enjoyed just Cape Cod itself, really. I mean, they had a goal to try to every ice cream place on the Cape, and they did it on a daily basis, and I know they had their favorites, and that's something that they really loved to do.
I wanted to work out, and he goes, okay, well, if you want to work out, you got to come with me. I said, okay, that's fine, what time? And he goes, well, I'm gonna work out at about 6 a.m. I was like, okay. So, you know, we'd go, and one time I asked him, I go, why do you work out so early? And he goes, well, if I don't, then when I come back, you know, if I work out at 8 or something like that, the girls are up and I've missed hanging out with them for an hour. He goes, I try to make sure that I get my workout done, and by the time I get back, I have enough time to hang out with them before the game. You know, and then as soon as the game's over, right back to being a dad.
What kinds of things did you see?
Love, and just a joy for life for all of them.
I think the coolest part was that we got to hang out a lot, you know? We got to hang out after the games, on off days, go to the beach together, and it was just a really good experience.
I mean, him and JJ, they had a special relationship. Baseball was their bond. But those girls had a really special place in his heart, all three of them.
You've been talking about values that your father and the other important people in your life gave you. What's special about the fact that from these people you got these values that you can now pass on in the world like they do?
Yeah, no, I think it's really important to who I become as a person, as a man, as how I'm gonna be as a husband, and in the role I'm gonna serve for Lexi going forward. I just think that that's so important. I mean, you can be really successful and you can do a lot of things in life, but if you're not a good person and not doing things for the right reason, and you don't treat everybody with respect, then none of that matters. So that's just something that I know Lexi already has that inside her. She's literally has the biggest heart. So I know that she's gonna continue to do that. It's been unreal, the amount of support and love that our family has gotten in this situation. And it just, again, just shows how special that my dad, Carrie, and Alyssa all were.
It's pretty cool. thank you guys so much for coming. It really means a lot to all of us. On behalf of me, Lexi, and Carly, we can't thank everyone here enough. The amount of love and support we've received these past few weeks has been truly amazing. Each text, call, donation, or act of kindness is not gone unnoticed. It really shows the impact that my dad, Kay, and Lissa had on everyone here. I was going to get up here and talk about my dad, Kay, and Lissa, but there's no way for me to put what they meant to me into words. The people that we have selected to speak about them today will paint the perfect picture of who they are. The legacy they left will continue to live on through all of us. But for tonight, let's all live by my dad's favorite motto, you drinking or thinking. Thank you, guys.
Looked at me and said, best start putting first things first. 'Cause when your hourglass runs out of sand, you can't flip it over and start again. Take every breath God gives you for what it's worth. Don't blink. Just like that, you're 6 years old and you take a nap, and you wake up and you're 25. Then your high school sweetheart becomes your wife. Don't blink. It just might be.
Hello, my name is Clark Smith. It was my honor and privilege to call John Altobelli my best friend for over 45 years. A friendship that not surprisingly started on a baseball field. When John and his family moved into the area from Chicago after a quick pit stop in the San Diego area. On a baseball team coached by his father, Jim, who, not coincidentally, was a fine coach and a mentor of young men himself. A friendship with Alto that would span for 5 decades. Filled with wins and losses, graduations, marriages, births of children, passing of parents, and all the joys and sorrows, the twists and turns that life brings. Spending time with John and his family, seeing the years pass, watching our respective children grow and flourish, gave us pause to occasionally sit down, have a beer, count our gray hairs, and agree that we were two pretty fortunate guys. And even talk about what the next chapter in life may bring for us and our family. But in the blink of an eye, the world changed. Over the past 2 weeks, I've had some time to reflect on my years with Alto. What was it about Alto as a person that created this lasting bond and friendship for decades? The answer was pretty straightforward. The same qualities and characteristics that guided John as a teacher on the field, a teacher in the classroom, a coach on the field, a father, a husband, a mentor, was the same as a friend. What were those words? Loyalty, trust, respect, work ethic, and love. Powerful words, but Alto backed them up every day. You will undoubtedly hear some of those same words used by others speaking today about John, as well as Carrie and Lissa. Those same traits can be found in Lexi and JJ. Alto, Carrie, and Lissa are not here with us today in person, but how they lived their lives and the positive influence that they had upon me is here today. From Alyssa's infectious smile and drive as a fierce competitor, to Carrie's passion and dedication to be the best mother and wife to her family, to Alto's continuous commitment to make a difference in young people's lives. The three of them touched us in so many ways and made us better persons. They touched us in some profound and powerful ways, but also in some subtle ways. One of the enduring qualities of John and his large Irish-Italian family was humor. A wry, witty humor, often employing one-liners, delivered with a straight face and no warning, but always followed by a smile and a laugh. His one-liners could turn a tough time into a smile. The master of this brand of the Alto humor was John's late mother, Pat. But it could be delivered by any Altobelli at any time. The one-liners and laughing with Alto is just one of many things that I will miss about him, but there will ever, forever be a part of me. For those of us that were fortunate enough to have Alto, Carrie, and Alyssa as part of our lives, we were truly blessed. For those that didn't get to meet them or spend time with them, I hope that the stories you hear today, the positive messages of how they lived their lives and made life better for those around them, will in some way touch you and be a positive influence on how you live your life. I am certain it is a message they would want to be told in their memory. Forever a pirate. Thank you.
Yeah, when I get where I'm going,
there'll be only happy tears. I will shed the sins and struggles I have carried all these years, and I'll leave my heart wide open. I will love and have no fear.
Thank you, JJ, Lexi, and Carly, for this honor today. I'd like to begin with a quote that I feel summarizes the essence of my best friend, Carrie. When you give yourself permission to communicate what matters to you in every situation, you will have peace despite rejection and disapproval. Putting a voice to your soul helps you let go of the negative energy of fear and regret. I'm Lori Lever, and Carrie was not only my bestie for 30 years, she was also my mentor, something I don't think I ever told her. As I reflect back on the life that Carrie lived, I can confidently say that she had great conviction, and she made no apologies. She never settled, and she definitely left this earth without regret. While I still want to believe that this is a bad dream, I know it's true. In an instant on the morning of January 26th, the world lost 9 important people. John, Carrie, Alyssa, Kobe, Gianna, Peyton, Sarah, Christina, and Ara. Thank you all for coming today to celebrate these three amazing people, John, Carrie, and Alyssa. This afternoon, I'd like to share with you some of the special qualities that I admired in my best friend, Carrie. To begin with, Carrie was tough. She and I met through work about 30 years ago, and we didn't exactly hit it off right away. As a matter of fact, she scared the living crap out of me. This is something we often joked about. One of the last quote memes she texted me was, and I'm sorry if this is inappropriate, but I'm gonna do it anyway. Every good friendship starts with, when I first saw you, I thought you were a bitch. For Carrie and I, this was 100% true. Carrie treated me like a sister. Fortunately for me, our paths crossed again after that rocky initial introduction, and we found ourselves traveling together for business, where we had plenty of time to warm up to each other. I thank God that He didn't allow me to judge a book by its cover, because when I had the opportunity to read all the pages, I found my best friend, who truly felt like a sister. Carrie was a true mentor to a lot of people. As I mentioned, I don't think that Carrie knew I saw her as a mentor, and I wish that I would have told her so. I admired how she embraced a strong set of values to which she held herself and everyone in her circle accountable. No mistaking it, Carrie was brutally honest and straightforward. I was in awe of her determination to overcome the adversity and sadness she had experienced in her childhood in order to build the life and family with Alto that she always wanted. Through her example, she taught me how to live with conviction and how not to fall prey to being the victim, ever. Carrie was loyal and had a small, tight inner circle of friends. Her main focus was her family, so her inner circle of friends was tight. Carrie was private. She didn't let a lot of people in. Deep down, Carrie was loving and extremely loyal. I was honored to be a part of her inner circle and to have the opportunity to see Carrie from the inside out. It was because of this intense loyalty, along with her strong set of values and her love of God, my husband Dave and I chose Carrie to be the godmother to our 1-year-old son, Xander. I know without a shadow of a doubt, she is still looking out for Xander, even from heaven. I had the privilege of experiencing many major life events with Carrie, where we shared many laughs and many tears. From marriage to divorce, birth to death, disappointment and triumphs, vacations, holiday work, and so much more. There was one particular instance, actually probably multiple, when I know I failed Carrie, and I really let her down. Excuse me. In spite of that, she was still there for me when I needed her. That's the thing about friendship. You can laugh, support, fight, and fail each other. Yet the love and bond forever stays intact. Our friendship truly stood the test of time. Carrie was focused, and her only mission was to be a great wife, mother, and friend. I looked up to Carrie because of how she thoughtfully placed her marriage as a solid foundation on which she built her family. She even went as far as telling me that without Alto, the pieces to her precisely crafted puzzle of a life would disassemble. Without a doubt, Carrie had an unwavering love for and dedication for her family. It was clear that she woke up each day devoted to supporting and honoring her husband and three children. Her family was all she truly cared about. She was a proud wife and mother who supported and bragged about her family every second she got. It was no secret to Carrie's friends that if you wanted to see her, you needed to come over to their house because she didn't want to sacrifice any time away from her family. And guess what? The kids felt the same way too. Carrie's devotion to her family was admirable. Carrie embraced everything her family did. As her girls grew up, their personal passions became Carrie's passions. Managing the family schedule with baseball commitments for Alto, basketball for Alyssa, tennis and academics for Lexi, supporting JJ as he pursued a career in baseball like his dad, and the demands of Carrie's own business left little time for anything else. Often it was at the expense of spending time with others, but that's how Carrie wanted to do it, and she did it without regret. From the day she met Alto, she engulfed herself in baseball and attended every single game, both home and away, making sure their two young girls were always with them. She immediately embraced JJ as her son and loved him like he was her own. As her best friend and a new mom, I can tell you that watching her do this effortlessly was nothing short of amazing. Carrie lived her truth boldly without apologies. Carrie was one of the bravest and unabashed people I've ever known. She can be described as strong, direct, real, unapologetically bold, hardworking, and brutally honest because she cared. She stood up for herself, her family, and her close inner circle. If you knew Carrie, you knew not to mess with her, her family, or those close to her. She was a force to be reckoned with, the queen of follow-through. Even the dogs knew not to mess with Carrie. Without a doubt, her conviction to stay true to herself was so strong that she never let the opinions of others change who she was or influence her next move. Carrie oftentimes came across as if she didn't care what others thought of her boldness, but I know for certain she cared deeply. She was just protecting the den. I'm confident that Carrie lived a life of significance rather than regret, knowing in her heart that she left the world better than she found it, knowing that she made a difference in the lives of those in her inner circle, knowing that she spent her last day on earth doing exactly what she loved, going to a basketball game with her bright light of a daughter, Alyssa, alongside her warm and funny husband, Alto. And finally, knowing that she created something beautiful in the legacy of her family. J. JJ, Lexi, Carly, remember, once a family, always a family. You guys are always close, whether on earth and them in heaven. You guys were always together, and ride or die, and here you are, and you're still there. Thank you so much.
My heart feel like an ember, and it's lighting up the dark. I'll carry these torches for ya, and you know I'll never drop. Yeah, everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, yeah, yeah. But everything gon' be alright, gon' raise a glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got, oh. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the dreams bring back all the memories of everything we've been through.
AKA my baseball family. I actually met Altobelli, Alto, in the summer of 1975. He was 12, I was 15. My summer job in high school was with Harbor Area Baseball, coaching and working clinics. We crossed paths for many years. High school at Newport Harbor. We both played at Golden West for Coach Fred Hoover. I would stop by UCI when he coached there. And when he started at Coast, I would stop by also. In 2002, I told him my son Junior was interested in playing at Coast. Junior earned the opportunity to play for Alto. At the end of the 2004 season, Alto asked me if I'd like to coach for Coast. I started in the fall of 2004 and finished a great run with Alto in 2019. If it wasn't for him, I never would have had the opportunity to get back to the game and meet my best friends. On January 22nd, I had a dream I was coaching with Alto. On the 23rd, he texted me, and all he said was, "Miss you." So I texted him back that I had been dreaming about coaching with him. I asked him how the team was looking. "Are you scrimmaging at 10 o'clock on Saturday?" He said, "The team looks good. Yes, we're scrimmaging at 10. Hope to see you Saturday." I told him I was planning on coming by to see him. I was at the field Saturday for about 3 hours, just talking with a few people and Alto. And when it was time to say goodbye, I said, "I'll see you Tuesday for opening day." That was the last time we talked. Please remember Alto for all the special moments he gave us. He always treated me as if I was his brother. He embraced my family as if they were his. Thank you, Alto, for the opportunity. I love you. I love you, my friend.
Alto taught young men the skills required to be great fathers, husbands, brothers, and sons. Teachers, coaches, CEOs, and mentors. Skills to help navigate a professional world filled with executive meetings or career fighting fires and helping others. The career path didn't matter. It was always translated. In the Alto world of teaching, there was never a wasted lesson. There was never a time he said something to you that he didn't expect it to be consumed, digested, and utilized. He was strategic in his teachings. He gave you what he knew you could handle, and that was usually more than what you thought you could. He polished your strengths, and he mitigated your weaknesses. He wasn't a great coach because he knew the X's and O's better than anybody else, or because he knew when to steal, hit and run, or bunt. Hell, he was pretty conservative when it came to offensive action. He was great because he could take 40 people and convince them to all pull the rope in the same direction, and to pull it in the precise way that he had taught them. He possessed a rare quality, a quality shared by only the greatest of leaders, the quality of successful leadership. It's not simply the ability to lead, but the ability to get others to follow willingly and in a way that achieves the greatest of goals. The percentage of great leaders is small, but the percentage of successful leaders is even smaller. He was the best of the best, the top gun. He was a winner, and he hated to lose more than he liked to win. And he wanted it plain vanilla. No sprinkles, no cherry. He taught people to be a fountain and to spread positive energy, not a drain that would suck the life out of a team. He was my coach, and my mentor, and my friend. Not a day goes by that I don't use a skill that he taught me. I will never be the same man that I was 2 weeks ago. I will be better, because even today, standing up here, he is teaching me still. Forever Pirate.
I stand here today in front of all of you to tell you about a pretty remarkable person. If I had knew that Friday, January 24th, was the last time I was gonna see her, I would have smiled a little more, complained a little less, and lived in the moment as if it were my last. Alyssa was the funniest, most caring girl I have ever met. She always had my back and supported me no matter what. She always put others' needs before hers. I remember when we used to play on the same basketball team when we were younger, she used to do a bunch of cool moves until she had a wide open shot. Instead of shooting it and probably making her 12th basket, she would pass it to me so I could make my first. When I missed, she would look at me with a smile and say, "Good try, you'll get the next one." But when I made it, we would look at each other with wide eyes and she would always give me a big high five. She always was doing her best to make people happy and make them feel good about themselves. As we all know, Alyssa was a devoted basketball player. She would practice and practice. She lived down the street from me, and I would always see her practicing outside. She never stopped. Alyssa had the hardest work ethic out of anyone I've ever known. She always worked 110%, even when no one was watching. She was dedicated to the game and always played with a purpose. I would always ask her to hang out, and almost every time she would say, "Sorry, I have basketball." But the times we would get to hang out, it was always a blast. She was lots of fun to be around. We could talk and laugh for hours and hours about literally anything. We used to live on the same street, and every day after school, we would ride our bikes home and go to her house. When Alyssa first moved into that house, we were practically attached at the hip. I spent a lot of time with her and her parents. Mr. and Mrs. Altobelli always welcomed me into their home with open arms. They were super loving and kind towards me. There's truly never a dull moment at their house. After school, I didn't have to text my parents I was at the Altobellis because they already knew I was there. They always had the best food at their house, so we would eat a snack and then play for hours. She would teach me new basketball moves and I would teach her soccer moves. We played video games and would hang out in her backyard for hours. She was an avid animal lover. She liked almost every animal except hairless cats. In sixth grade, she thought the turtles in the science classroom were being mistreated, so she took them home from the classroom and kept them as her pets. She had the biggest heart and was always caring towards everyone. I already miss her so much, her smile, her sarcastic personality, and pretty much just everything about her. Alyssa, thank you for 8 years of friendship, 8 years of laughter, and 8 years of smile. I will always do my best to make you proud. I know you will always be cheering me on. I'll never forget any of the memories we had. Alyssa Altobelli, another angel in heaven, another star in sky, and 15 letters we will never forget. Thank you.
So what we go out, that's how it's supposed to be. Living young and wild and free.
Fine, and we don't care who sees.
We don't care who sees.
That's how it's supposed to be.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Derek Sanders. Carrie was my sister. Alto was my brother-in-law. And Alyssa was my niece. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank and acknowledge everyone for making this memorial possible. Thank you all for your time, planning, thoughtfulness, donations, and empathy. Completing something like this under the best of circumstances is nothing short of exceptional. Managing it under the duress of the current conditions is simply remarkable. Thank you all so much for your extraordinary care. I want to offer my most sincere condolences and prayers to the Bryants, the Chesters, the Mausers, and the Zubayans. All of us lost mothers, fathers, husbands, wives, sisters, brothers, family, friends, and loved ones. It requires no emphasis that this tragedy is forever indelibly marked on our hearts. I'm incredibly saddened and devastated by these losses. My thoughts and prayers are with you all, individually and collectively. Briefly, my family. Carrie was my sister. She's 2 years younger than me and has been the closest person in my life for the last 46 years. Carrie was a courageous, loyal, hardworking, caring friend, sister, and mother. She worked hard in school and was always a very loyal friend, and later an exemplary employee. She met Alto and was married. The two of them invited me into their lives as Carrie approached motherhood. Carrie worked tirelessly in support of this family. Simply, as Lori already stated, for those that did not know her, Carrie was a force. An incredibly caring woman that exhibited passion in all areas of her life. My life was forever changed when Alexis and Alyssa were born. I became an uncle. I was completely smitten. My heart was taken with these two amazing young people. I have rarely missed a weekend or an important family event in the last 16 years. Sundays became my favorite day of the week because of them. In my opinion, Alto was nothing short of a saint. Of course, this family loved and supported baseball, but in my relationship with Alto, I saw a man who sacrificed tremendously because of the love and devotion he had for his family.
I never saw him exhibit his widely known fiery behavior on the field and their home. This was a cohesive family that laughed and evolved lovingly together. Graciously, Alto even put up with Uncle D. From my perspective, he was a spectacular father and husband. Frankly, we all idolized him. My niece, Alyssa, was nicknamed Love Bug by my mom before she passed away 14 years ago. Alyssa was super fun, an amazing friend to others, and embraced most things with ease and grace. She had the most infectious laugh. My fondest memories were our group hugs, when we'd tickle each other mercilessly and laugh hysterically. Later, they teased me about uncomfortable Uncle D stories and stories their mom told them that I didn't remember, which often started a laugh fest amongst Alyssa, Alexis, and me. Alyssa was a naturally gifted athlete, in my opinion. I loved watching both girls play sports and rarely missed events. Thankfully, I was tolerated. Those that know me know what I mean. I adore these girls and love spending time with this family. I know that they knew they were everything to me. And I'm so grateful I got to spend my time with them. I'm forever gonna miss our times together. My remaining life's devotion will be to Lexi. Excuse me. As I close, I want to express how grateful I am for everyone reaching out and supporting JJ and Alexis. All the prayers, cards, messages, meals, and generosity. It has been an incredible display of love and support. I truly have no time or words to thank you enough. While the lives of Carrie, Alto, and Alyssa are lost to this physical world in which we live, as evident in the world outpouring of love and support, their individual legacies of courage, loyalty, family, fortitude, laughter, and love will live in and through us all. With our remaining time, my hope is that we are challenged to wake up, serve, and carry these legacies in our hearts, thoughts, and actions, thus ensuring that their spirits will remain here with us. Our beloved family and friends are gone, but they will not be forgotten. Thank you all so much for being here today.
This goes out to all the women in the world, especially her. You know, it don't even matter your age, don't even matter your color. Your fellas, I ain't forget about y'all. This is for everybody to like things. Just listen to what I'm saying and do it and take a chance. I put my hand up on your hip. When I dip, you dip, we dip. You put your hand up on my hip. When you dip, I dip, we dip. I put my hand up on your hip. When I dip, you dip, we dip. You put your hand up on my hip.
Alto actually liked that song. I think it was the only move he could do. He said, if you listen to the chorus, it says, I put my hand on my hip, when you dip, we dip, you dip. And he would just say it randomly. We're here today to honor a family that touched so many lives in so many ways. A family that I felt a part of. Alto was not just a coach. He was a dad to JJ, Alyssa, Lexi, and a loving husband to Kay. He was also a dear friend to me and my family. He was my mentor and ultimately like my big brother. Kay, as we called her, was a firecracker, and she was Alto's biggest fan. You could just see the way she lit up when she talked about him. If you knew Kay like we did, she would let you know exactly where you stood with her. She was not afraid to speak her mind. She loved Alto and her kids just the same, and that would just resonate from her. I always enjoyed to get Kay fired up. I would tease her and say, Alto and the boys are taking a trip to Vegas, as we often did. But Kay would fire back, yeah, right, Bilo. You see, Kay knew that when Alto and the boys got together, there was a chance for a Hangover sequel. Our kids grew up together while I was an assistant coach for Alto, and we were fortunate to see JJ, Lexi, and Alyssa all grow up. I can remember our old team photos with JJ right in the middle, sitting on someone's shoulders. We had a designated room at their house that Alto called the Bilo Suite, which was just JJ's room, but he was gone for the night. Our kids would have their slumber party, and the big kids would indulge in a little Captain Morgan, watch movies that typically consisted of Old School, Superbad, and Wedding Crashers. Alto loved to recite one-liners. He would recite them that all in the know would get a laugh from. We would call each other or text each other those one-liners back and forth. If you ever got to hang out with Alto and watch a comedy flick, he would start to laugh and laugh so hard that the laugh turned to tears, and oftentimes we couldn't breathe from crying that ensued. As the kids have gotten older and life happens, we did not each see each other as often as we would have liked to. We would often catch up over a text, a phone call, or through JJ whenever I would see him on the scouting trail. So I always felt connected and up to date with the family no matter what. Alto was so proud of his family, and he would tell me about Alyssa and her basketball, and of course her awesome coach. He brought Lexi this summer to the area code game so she can network with baseball coaches and scouts as she has aspirations to work in the game. He talked about Kay being busy working for her uncle's business. He was also excited about JJ's scouting career, and you could just tell how proud he was of his family. I'm gonna miss going to OCC and walking over to the dugout to see Alto, which was always my first stop. I would then make my way to what I called Kay's VIP section, down the first baseline, where you could see her sitting in a chair with the girls and watching the game. I always felt special when I went over there because Kay would give me a hug and not a dirty look. When I think of Alto, I think of selfless. He was always helping his family, friends, and players. The impact he made on so many young men's lives will truly never be measured. We can tally his 700 plus wins, his 4 state championships, and his 100 ejections. Just kidding. I'm not sure how many he actually had, but he had his fair share when his alter ego, Norman, would come out. But we have no clue how many teachers, police officers, firefighters, dads, and husbands that he helped develop along the way. Those are the wins that he cherished the most. And to see his players come back and thank him for making an impact on their lives is what mattered to him. I owe so much to Alto because he gave me my first opportunity to coach and got me started as a 23-year-old in the game that I love. He showed me how to do things right, and he showed me how to do it with class and dignity. He pushed me to go back to school and get my degrees, and he even helped me pay for some of it. I will forever be grateful for the advice, direction, and leadership that he provided me with. So it's only fitting that Kay, Alyssa are being honored, and Alto, of course, are being honored at a Major League stadium. They were truly Major League people. I can continue to tell stories and share memories of the wonderful times that we spent on and off the field, as my head is full of them. I think about JJ and Carly this summer as they're gonna walk down the aisle, and Lexi graduating high school and heading off to college next year, and how special those times are supposed to be. For them, they will still be special, but they will also have a huge void that none of us could ever fill. We know we can never replace those amazing people, but we will do our best to be there for you. So what now? Squeeze your loved ones, enjoy today, and remember how precious life is. As much as we plan and prepare for tomorrow, the one thing that is evident to me is that tomorrow is not promised to any of us. Life gives us so much joy and happiness, but it can also give us pain and heartache. I wrote something down the other day that I think all of us can use in those times of sadness. When it starts to hurt, just remember the laughs and the good times Alto, Kay, and Alyssa left with us.
When you cry, be sure to dry your eyes, 'cause better days are sure to come. When you smile, be sure to smile wide, and don't let them know that they have won. And when you walk, walk with pride. Don't show the hurt inside, because the pain will soon be gone. And when you dream, dream big, as big as the ocean blue. When you dream, it might come true. But when you dream, dream big.